Hello, my lady loves. Welcome back to Kara's Love Techniques. We are here with our second episode of the Women's Dating Series. So today we are talking about three of the common mistakes that women make while dating or in relationships, okay? So I am going to try not to become too passionate about what I deliver today. If I do, forgive me. Just know it's coming from a place of love, all right? So let's get started. So the first topic that I want to talk about is when we come into our relationships or dating, right? And this is something that generally takes place when the both of you have come to some sort of consensus to, hey, we're together, we're committed. Even if it is not vocalized, you know, there still is some level of, you know, commitment there. Okay, regardless if it's not stated or not, it's there. So what typically happens is that throughout the course of your relationship, and it could be in the beginning or the end, you simply start giving your man what he needs. You know, it could be for something very bad or negative, or just simply deviate. You know, perhaps you two are too busy. He's working extra hours, you're working, you have kids, and you somehow fell off. Well, regardless if you are aware of that or not, that is a major mistake. It's even more severe when the two of you are in a bad place. Because, you know, granted, he may not have, let's just say, done something that you asked that was very significant and important to you. So now you may have an attitude for, you know, a couple of days. But yet when he comes home and he complains that his feet hurt, the only thing that you give him is, well, did you take out the trash? Or if you don't reside together, you give him some sort of, you know, lip service or whatever. You're not compassionate and consoling. See, as women, we are naturally known to be nurturers, attentive, caring. All right. And when we deviate from that behavior, and yes, we are. If you are not, show me a woman who was not born into this world to not be highly nurturing or attentive, caring, one of the three. And I'll show you a man. Okay. So show me a woman who was not brought into this world to be those qualities that women were designed to have. Okay? And I'll show you a man, because if you're not any of those three things, something is, you should seriously have yourself checked. And I don't mean that in a facetious way. I'm just saying, because when a man brings you into his life, albeit he wants you as a housewife, you know, someone to console him, his whole intent on doing that is to have someone who's going to be there, not 100% of the time, but when he needs it. See, we all need whatever we need on different levels. So it really depends on your person and his needs. So when he comes home and he complains, considering you two just had words a day or two ago and you're still venting, and he's complaining that he's in pain, and you show zero level of compassion, he's never going to forget that. Now, they may forget birthdays and anniversaries or whatever, but the fact that you did that, that would be etched in his brain. Okay? And then as time goes on, even after he's corrected his wrong and he does something else, and then whatever you do, is your attitude is so negative, and to the point to where you just completely just begin to just fall off with giving him what he needs. He's going to remember that. Men, they have a keen memory when it comes to negativity with women. They remember all of your flaws from the very beginning to the end. And there's so much, their capacity for that is so minimal that they can't take a lot of hurt, rejection, whatever it is that you're not giving, or perhaps you're giving too much of the wrong thing. They can only take the minimal amount of that. And once they reach that breaking point, that's when you get problems out of your person. We cannot stop giving someone what they need, especially when we've committed to them in some way or another. Because when you go into a partnership, generally, and hopefully this is discussed at the beginning, generally, you're agreeing to care for this person a certain way because we express what we need and what we desire from a person. And you know, hey, I have to have this, but I don't need too much of this. You see what I'm saying? So when you come in and then you begin to deviate or just stop it all together, that's not fair. And regardless of what the person is doing, I don't care if your guy is out all night, you know, being disloyal, whatever the case may be, you never deviate. And here's why. Because at the end of the day, you want to say you continue to do what you were supposed to do in that relationship. Not give him more of a reason or excuse to do or not do something. You see what I'm saying? Because you kind of came into this situation or relationship with somewhat of a commitment, right? And you have to uphold your end of the bargain, regardless if he does not. Because at the end of the day, you can walk away saying, hey, I did what I was supposed to do. I gave it my all. That's on him because he couldn't get back right and get it together. But one of the mistakes, one of the main mistakes women make is simply not giving their man what they need consistently. Consistent. You can't start cooking 3 or 4 days a week for him and then just fall back to one day. Now you want to eat out all the time or whatever. You're too busy. You can't really do that. I mean, you can, but it's not fair. You see what I'm saying? So the point is just give your man what he's supposed to have, regardless if he deserves it or not. Okay? All right. Secondly, we want to talk about expectations. Listen, ladies, my lady love bugs. You are not going to get everything you need or want from every and any man. Okay? I'm not saying that's not possible. That's not likely. I'm sure there is a human being out there somewhere, probably far deep into the forest, wherever in the corners of the earth, that is going to give you everything you need and desire at least 95%. We can't come into these situations expecting someone to be our all and be all, you know, our everything. Oh, when I get this age, I want my husband and he's going to be this and he has to have this. Or my next guy and, because see, Daryl, he didn't do this and he didn't do that. And then my other ex after him, he didn't do this, that, and that. And then the one after him, he didn't do this, that, 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 and that. So this next guy, and he better do this, 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 and this. Whoa. Whoa, that's a lot. I mean, just living is hard enough for the average human, okay? And to just get up every morning is a feat for most individuals. So for you to want whatever it is that you desire on such a high level, I'm not going to say it, but I mean, anything is possible, but more so than likely, you're setting yourself up for great disappointment. Most men can't give that. Why? Here's why. Okay. So you take a guy who starts out as, okay, adolescent years, college or college, coming out of high school, college years, he meet his first crush, or he's infatuated like heavily. He thinks it's really love. She's into him, but then she somehow betrays him. That has a major effect on him. So even though she was the ideal female for him in his eyes, now going forward, he's built up some sort of pent up energy towards women, regardless of who she is. So there you go, you have that issue. So now everyone comes into his life, he's gonna treat them, not as much, less than, treat her like she's promiscuous or thought or gold digger or whatever. And most guys are like that. They can have one little setback. I won't call it little. I will not, undermine how they felt about the person. But they can have one disappointing relationship or situation, and it has an overall effect on how they feel going forward. So because of that, you take this guy who he showered her with gifts, compliments, affection. He was caring, he was giving, he was respectful, he was a gentleman. He listened to her. He probably gave her all that, even if he wasn't in his earlier years and in his 20s, when he learned to kind of like be that type of person for the person he wanted to be that way with, and it went kaput. It set him back. So going forward, all of these situationships he's in, they're meaningless to him. And he's going to treat you like that, even if you are worthy. You see what I'm saying? So men have a way of going through certain things and having traumas to where they're not going to be able to give you their all. They may have a different perspective. They feel differently about people, women, and relationships altogether now. Again, it could be just one person that affected them like that. Whereas you have a guy who's a little tougher, Let's take him, he's in his 30s, maybe 35. He's dated quite a few, even been married and divorced. Now he has setbacks or things that he will not be willing to do for a woman any longer unless she proved herself in such a way for such a length of time to where he wants to come back to that level of emotion for her, for any woman. You see what I'm saying? So, having said that, it's very unlikely in this day and time that you're going to get a man to be your everything. He could be a workaholic. He pays the bills. He, gives you money, whatever it is. My grandfather, he would work like 17 and 18 hours every day, like 6 days a week. Seven children and a wife. Do you think my grandmother, whom I've never met, had any time with him, like real time, like quality time? No. And it was get off from work, eat a hot meal, maybe get him a little some, sleep a few hours, and then do it all again the next day. And it was even that way back then. Women had to put up with a lot. They may not have argued about it because they couldn't. They knew that they were chosen for whatever reason. So they just coped, found a way to cope with it. So this has always been, you see what I'm saying? It's always been this great imbalance. And that's usually going to be that way with men. See, we see it differently as women because we're all givers. We can juggle, what I'm saying? Two jobs, a family or a child, friends, mom, dad, all of these responsibilities. We know how to juggle. We can do it. So in our mind, it's like, hey, can't you, not hang out with the fellas? No, he cannot, because that's how he comes back down to earth, how he unwinds. You see what I'm saying? So yeah, I say all of that to say this. you're simply not going to get everything you want from a man. So the only thing that I could suggest is to minimize your expectations. Like, have like two set priorities. He has to be this, and he has to give me this emotionally. You know what I'm saying? So, and just the rest, you just kind of have to deal with it, unfortunately. All right, and so the next topic. Ladies, we always say we want a real man, right? Yeah, we've all said it, even under our breath. But here's the thing, when men hear that, especially today, in this era, for the past, let's say, 15, 20 years, men have seen women differently. Why? Because we're like smoke and mirrors. We're like an illusion to them. So for most men, we have to prove how real we are, how honest, how credible, organic, any of those kind of words. We have to prove that to them simply because of our outward appearance. Now, I know we like to look like how we like to look. You know, we have our fake hair. You know, we put on our makeup. That's an illusion, making your eyes look larger or smaller. Your lips look bigger with a certain type of lipstick and fillers. We have fillers in our cheeks. We have the false eyelashes. Let's go down. We have fake breasts. We've gotten that lipo and put it in our butts. There's that. Okay, we have fake nails. Pedicures, our jewelry, how real is that? That Fendi bag, how real is that? You know, when they see us, they see a walking, I don't know, it's just a walking fake person. Now, put yourself in their shoes. If a man were to be that way, everything about him on him was not his, was not real. It was added in addition. Granted, it looks good, but still, it's not real. And so now you have to wonder, how much hair does he really have? Or what does her smile really look like without that bright lipstick on? Okay. What about this? You know, they have so many questions in their mind because now they have to put in extra work to try to determine if you are an honest person, regardless of how conniving and deceitful and manipulative and whorish a man is. When he looks at a woman, he wants her to be a certain way. So when you come off a certain way, just by the way you look, he may be completely wrong because you could be highly educated, you know, multiple degrees, self-assured, self-aware, confident, have great esteem, humorous, have a wonderful personality and aura about yourself. But then as you're walking towards him, you're giving off something else completely different. You see what I'm saying? So we have to put ourselves in their shoes as to why they approach us and why they don't take us seriously, especially in the beginning. You kind of have to warm up to that. He has to wait and see. Okay, so my last girl was just like that. You know, she didn't wear real hair, eyelashes. All of this was extra, so much. You know, are you like that too? Okay, not just my last girl, but the girl before that, and the girl before that, and the girl before that. Yeah, they all wear their hair like. So we're being put into the same boat, you know? We're being seen the same way, even though we're all different, and having to work twice as hard to prove ourselves. And now we're wondering why we were ghosted. Because guys are just not willing to put in that much work these days. I'm being real. We've changed drastically over the past 15 to 20 years. And it's new to them. It's like, do I really want to put in the work and the effort to see if she is who she says she is? Think about it. Like, come on. Let's make it make sense from their perspective. So having said all of that to say this, keep it as real as you possibly can. And I want to add something else that just came to me. Because we have to put in so much work and proving ourselves, the best thing that you can do is to show your personality, show who you are from the gate. And I mean, not all at once, but over the course of weeks, show your happy side, your funny side. Show that you're agitated that day. You know, you really don't feel like being bothered. Show those sides. Show all facets of you. Why? Because this is his way of getting to know you and just speaking about what you are or who you are. Not all at once. Don't give it to him all at once. You want him to warm up to you and to build up to you. This also allows him to open up. See, we have a big issue with men being closed off because they've been wounded. Even a little bit, they close off. And we have to fight tooth and nail to get just meaningful dialogue from them. When you open up and you begin to show who you are, I don't care who you are, what your personality is. You may be a wine drinker every day. Let him see that. Let him know that. Because you want him to be able to determine if that's something he's going to be able to accept or not. And then he can open up and show more things about him. You see what I'm saying? Versus you guys waiting 2 and 3, 4 months before you get, make any ground, you know, break the ground. You see what I'm saying? But as long as you can be yourself and show your true personality, either you're going to be for him or not. And you really want to do that anyway because the way you have presented yourself. Now, this is advice for my ladies who are all natural. Kudos to you. Okay? What they see is what they're going to get. Even still, when it comes to showing your personality, because they may not trust that, and you may have recently gone natural or become, you know, comfortable with just being in your natural state. He doesn't know that. So you're still going to have to put forth some effort as well by exposing your personality. And when I say your personality, I mean just that. I don't mean telling him that you've had 2 relationships, you were abused, you were mistreated, yada, yada, yada. No, you say that for like when you're like 8 months or a year in. Okay? When you know you guys are headed somewhere. We're not trying to run him away. Or we're not trying to give him an opportunity to do the same thing because they'll do it. Okay? If they know you're that tight, they'll take advantage of that. So you want to build up to who you are. This way, in the end, if there is an end, or when he comes to terms and say, hey, well, she isn't like how I thought she were. You know, how I thought she was. Huh, I was wrong. I thought it was an illusion, but no, she really is what I've kind of been looking for, you know, minus a few hiccups, but she really is that person. You see what I'm saying? So allowing it to build up, not exposing everything, this way you can also determine what his character is. Remember, people, it's all about learning one's character. The money, the cars, the house, the education, the degrees, none of that shit matters in the end. The only thing that truly matters is someone's persona, their character, their traits, how they acted. That's what usually it boils down to. That's why you break up, because the way a person was and treated you, right? Okay, so we need to focus on character, personality, traits, persona. Yeah? Okay. I'm getting too passionate. I'm going to leave it right there. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Let me know what you think. Let's talk about this. If not, I will catch you in the next video. Until next time.